Let us now discuss about refracting telescope. This is also called an astronomical telescope because this telescope is used to provide the angular magnification for heavenly object or far away located distance objects. Now, in reflecting telescope, here we can write, it provides angular magnification for distant objects and uses two lenses, objective and eyepiece for this purpose. And similar to compound microscope, objective is the one which is closer to the object, that is toward object side, and eyepiece is the one which is closer to the observer side. Only difference in this and microscope lenses are here, objective is of quite large aperture. This because as object is located far away, the intensity of light rays coming from object reduces to a very low value. So, objective is taken to be of large aperture so that as many light rays enter into the objective, the image intensity will be high. And as object is far away, all rays can be considered as paraxial. So, relative spherical aberration will be less. If we just have a look on optical setup of a telescope, here again we use two lenses and will analyze the study of image at two locations. One is at near point, other is at far point for the observer. This is objective having focal length F1 and this is the eyepiece having focal length FE. Now, if we consider from far away points, parallel rays are incident onto the objective, and say if this angle is alpha, which can be taken as the angular size of object, and if it is producing an image, intermediate image somewhere here, and say it is of height h, certainly the final image due to objective will be obtained in its focal plane, or the image distance from the objective lens would be equal to the focal length of the objective lens. And in this situation, this intermediate image will act as an object for eyepiece and light rays will incident on the eyepiece, and finally these light rays will be falling into the observer's eye and the final image will be seen by the observer. So in this situation, say if this is the location where the image is obtained, if this is the final image H prime, then here we can say due to these two diverging rays, final image will be seen by the observer at a point which is at a distance near point of the observer from eyepiece lens, as eye is considered to be very close to the eyepiece. Then in this situation we can say if this distance of intermediate image is UE from the eyepiece lens, then this angle beta we can consider as the angular size of image produced. So here we can write angular size of object. In this situation we write it as alpha, and the value of alpha we can write as h over fo, and if we calculate the angular size of image, this must be beta, and the value of beta we can calculate from this triangle, and it can be given as h over ue, where u is the distance of intermediate image from the eyepiece lens. So here magnifying power of telescope, if we calculate, then magnifying power of telescope we can write as angular size of image by angular size of object is beta by alpha. So, if we substitute the value of beta and alpha here, h gets cancelled out and the value we are getting is fo by ue. So, you must be very careful here that ue we can easily obtain by using lens formula for eyepiece lens. Say, if we use using lens formula for eyepiece, here we can say the object distance is minus UE, the image distance is minus D, and focal length can be taken as plus FE. If we use the values in lens formula, 1 by V minus 1 by U is 1 by F. Here you can see we are getting is minus 1 by D plus 1 by UE is equals to 1 by FE. On simplifying, we are getting the value of UE is equals to DFE over D plus FE. So if we substitute it over here, so here we can write for image produced at near point, the magnifying power of a refracting type telescope, which can be written as MP for image production at point D, will be FO by, here UE I can write as DFE multiplied by, this is the D plus FE. On simplifying, here I am getting MPD is equals to FO by FE multiplied by, this D can be taken in, this 1 plus FE by D. And as the final image produced is inverted, we can take this as a negative. And this is the magnifying power of a refracting type telescope when final image is produced at near point of the human eye. And if we consider the situation for image produced at far point, then here we know well, for this image to be produced at infinity, this UE must be equals to FE. So in this situation, if UE is equals to FE, we can see the value of beta will change to H over FE. So the only difference in this situation we are getting is directly the magnifying power of this telescope for image produced at infinity will be equals to, this directly written as FO by FE, and again it is negative because we are observing an inverted image. So these are the two magnifying powers for final image produced at near point or at far point in case of a refracting type telescope.